Respected Mr. Ranjit Bhattacharya, keynote speaker for today's session, Professor Dr. Ravikant Swami, Director, Delhi Metropolitan Education, Professor Dr. Amrit Saxena, Dean, DME Media School, and Director of Studios and Production at Delhi Metropolitan Education, Professor Dr. Susmita Bala, Head DME Media School, Dr. Purva Ranjan, Head DME Management School, and Head Mentoring Cell at DME, all faculty members from DME Media School and DME Management School, and my dear students. I'm Anmeet Kaur, extending my warm welcome to the orientation session for the first year batch 2020 of DME Media School and DME Management School students. Delhi Metropolitan Education is one of the premier educational institute affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University and approved by Bar Council of India. DME Media School is the branch dealing with 3 years BA in Journalism and Mass Communication course, and DME Management School offering 3-year BBA course for the students. Today, we have amongst us Mr. Arijit Bhattacharya, an acclaimed entrepreneur, business expert, artist, author, and specialist as game programmer and government advisor. He is the founder and CEO of Virtual Infocom, India's one of the first game development and virtual reality app development company, and the company was founded in the year 1998. He has over 22 years of experience for providing assistance and help for startups, entrepreneurs, and government across the world to solve problems using entrepreneurship, technology, and innovation. He is an international public speaker and has also invited as keynote speaker, panelist, and jury member at multiple global events, which includes new technology development, future of business startup events, angel investment forums, and to name a few. He has been awarded as the top rated global business leader, celebrated speaker, top influencer, blockchain specialist, and virtual reality specialist. He is the creator of more than 55 superheroes and 21 comic characters. He is also a TEDx speaker in various capacities. He has founded many portals related to virtual reality, gaming, animation, media, and entertainment sectors. Mr. Bhattacharya is also associated with various IT and non-IT projects. He has also contributed in the education sector by creating syllabus related to virtual reality and has been visiting the various international and national institutes as the visiting faculty. This is a very brief profile for our guest, and I request all the students and the participants who have joined this session to do visit www.arijitbhattacharya.com. I'm also posting the link in the chat box. Now, not taking much time, I request Dr. Purva Ranjan, Head DME Management School and Head Mentoring Cell at DME, to please share her welcome address.
Respected Amrit sir and Bala ma'am, and heartiest welcome to all the students, and great to have Mr. Arijit in the session. Although Manmeet ma'am has spoken a lot about your profile, but what I researched and I found most interesting is that you have traveled across 34 countries. And that is the most inspiring point to me, because as a constant learner and as faculty member, I think we have the best exposure towards cross-cultural understanding of people by traveling. And by traveling, we get to learn a lot more than what is taught in the class, because there's a whole lot of world beyond the four walls of the classroom. So I welcome Mr. Arijit, and I am eager to listen to you for the insightful session, and also the fact that you are a serial entrepreneur. And in today's world, we need students who need entrepreneurial thinking as well as an interest to start their own work and provide jobs to others, and not just be a job seeker, but a job provider. So with that perspective, I am very happy that you spare time to be here, because your word of guidance and motivation is going to really help the media and management students and who have just started their journey from their school and stepped into college. So you're the best person to guide them. Over to you, sir. Session is all yours.
Thank you so much for the beautiful introduction. I'm just a small dot in the vast universe. I'm nothing, just trying to do something good. Well, Because it's a student session, so usually if it's a physical meetup, I usually say that mere class mein city tali sab kuch chal sakta hai. But here, probably on an online session, mute would be the best possible way. But I would love to go for an interactive session rather than going for a non-interactive mode. So I'll give you a small background of my perspective, what's happening in the world, and probably what is there, what is coming up, and probably what are the kind of new technologies that is there. Not sure about how inspired you all will be. You have internet as a source for your information. So for the students, whatever you are watching in internet, you have your Google Baba as your probably guidance. So when you look at Google, when you search anything in Google, you get...
I am so sorry to interrupt you, sir, but your voice is not audible. I suppose there is some mic or audio issue at your end. It's very low, I suppose.
Give me a second. Is it fine now?
You were loud at the initial of the session, but now you are very, very, very slow.
Not sure. I've been...
Yes, sir. Yes. Now it's good.
It's good? Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir.
I'm so sorry. Okay. So when you search in Google, if you say, for an example, as a student, you're trying to get some kind of information from Google. How many of you do know that in Google, you can maximum access is 30%. The rest of the data you want to fetch is 70% data, which is not accessible to any one of you. And that can only accessed by real life interaction and real time communication. When you talk about data, when you talk about accessing the world, probably I'll share my life story with you and you can get an idea how things can happen. And then probably I can touch upon a few bit about latest generation technology that is happening across world and why Indians are trying to do good in probably trying to do a benchmark in the world, and what are the kind of education that is coming up, and what are the kind of disruption that is coming up in education world. Is it fine, Professor? Okay, super. So when I started, I started with pure without internet world, when computers was like a luxury, and the year was 1996. I was reading in class 10 standard. And when I was in school, I used to thrown out of my history classes because in history classes, I used to create comics. And I used to be a third bencher. That was my patent bench with four best friend of mine. And they used to be my, you can say, potential thought leaders, friends who can practically tell me that this superhero is not going to work. This character is like, okay type, you know, this is not what I'm looking for. And with all those discussions, my history teacher used to tell me, get out and kneel down out of my class. So that's the usual feedback initially I used to get. Now I was a science student and in class 11 standard, I have an inclinedness about the chemistry laboratory. The only reason is I used to create colors in those chemistry lab, even though there was syllabus, even though my teacher is telling me that, hey, you know what, you have to go with this kind of Bunsen burners, you have to mix this kind of elements. But after the class is over, I used to be the solo person in an empty chemistry lab doing all those kind of possible nonsense stuff that I can do. So I was actually creating colors from plastics, from flowers, from leaves, and I wanted to create an alternate source which can probably replace the chemical colors. Now I was a biggest failure, and I again from chemistry labs I used to be thrown out, and my chemistry teacher told me that, you know what, Arijit, this is not your place. You do your work, and after the class is over, you're not entitled to stay in chemistry lab for 30 seconds. So what I did, my I have an inclinedness about cooking. So I told my mom that, you know what, you give me your kitchen and I'm going to cook something which is really tasty. So if you look at the previous generation gas burners, we used to have two different knob. So in the first knob, I used to cook either probably chicken or some veg or sometimes noodles. And the second one, I used to create those kind of nonsense colors. So that is probably the starting phase when I felt that maybe science can change the world. I can change the world. I will create something which is really, really amazing. And people will be after me with money so that I can create a company. The myth break in the year of 1998. After class 12, I got a chance in engineering. I left that because I wanted to start my own venture. And when I started, I had a deep conversation with my father. And he asked me that, okay, fine, if you really want to do business, that is perfectly fine. I don't have any kind of issues. But you know what? You have to go through all the degrees and diplomas, whatever I'm looking for. And it was a conversation which started at 8:30 p.m. at night, went till 4 o'clock in the morning. And somehow I convinced him that, okay, fine, I'll get all the degrees that you look for, but I'm not going to go for any kind of engineering degree. That's wasting of my 4 years. Rather, I'll join economics and statistics and mathematics. That will probably give me some kind of idea about how to run business, how to make money, how to roll money. Sorry, students, that was another myth. So when I joined that college with economics, I understood, oh my God, this is all theory. This is not the practical stuff. So what to do? Can I create something which is really practical? Can that be done? What is the way out? Somehow, by God's grace, the supernatural power gave me a bit of gray matter in the brain. I started exploring the world which you call as computer world. There used to be a lot of cafes, like you can call them as a cyber cafe. And I used to explore new generation of computer language over there, try to learn it by on my own. And then in 98, for next 6 months, it was all learning, all understanding how to create animated character and then convert them into a programming channel and then probably make a very decent level of movement. It was all practice. It was all, you can say, trial and error, research and development, whatever I was doing in my childhood, all those superhero characters. I wanted to create something, some kind of amazing stuff for the world. And then I was touching upon few bit of people in the industry who can probably help me, probably guide me on creating such kind of animated characters into a gaming character. Market was not ready then, to be very specific. And I was looking for some opportunity out of India. I was looking for some opportunity within India. I was communicating with people, trying to understand whether there is a need or not, whether I can create some kind of ecosystem or not. And I used to be called as a crazy mad guy who don't have any kind of focus in life, who feel that he can probably disrupt the world. Time passed by. It was like 1999. I was just doing literally nothing but creating a small group of people who became my students. And they said, okay, fine, you can teach a little bit of decent. You're not teaching like normal teachers. Probably you're giving us some kind of guidance on programming. Probably you're giving us some kind of guidance on arts. We are ready to pay you. So they became my initial level of consumer. And I thought probably this is the best way. Let me create a team. And then after that, I'll go to the market. And because people used to tell me that you are crazy, you don't have any kind of dictionary language, I thought to create my own dictionary. So let me share my screen. Let me show you probably, is it visible? Just raise your hand. I'll know that it's visible. Super. Okay. So I have my own dictionary, which is probably, again, some crazy stuff. So I'm going to bore you for a couple of hours now. I'm going to bore you with few of the things which is probably disrupting the world and which is probably completely different whatever you have seen so far in the traditional animation or traditional gaming or traditional VR industry. But before I jump into it, the bore, the full meaning for my dictionary is beginning of re-engineered entrepreneurship. But when I started, there was no such word called entrepreneurship. It was all business. As per my small understanding, if you really want to create something disruptive, market usually don't accept you in the initial level. When you joined any kind of course, you feel that, okay, fine, this course is going to teach me whatever I want to do in my entire life. Trust me, you need to read a lot, you need to learn a lot, and you need to explore a lot. Whatever you are learning in your traditional syllabus is really good for making great marks. But if you really want to make a benchmark, you need to go beyond that. Now, when I tried to go beyond that, I started exploring a very dead language, which people say that nothing gonna happen with Sanskrit, nothing gonna happen with our old culture. Who cares about Indian culture? That's old one. And you Indians are usually with one snake with a few bit of flutes. And that's how India is, with full of slum, full of poor people. That gave me a kind of challenge. India is not that. India got lot of different variety of mythology, rich in culture. So somehow world doesn't know it. So probably if I talk on a storytelling method, if I talk on a structure where probably people can understand, okay, fine, this thing can be done as well. The old myth can be converted into a realistic story as well. So here we got our first India's first RPG game, which we published in a PC platform long back in 2000-2001. The game was called Ashwatthama the Immortal. I'm not sure whether you know the character. This is a character from Mahabharata. And why Ashwatthama? According to the mythology, according to the legends, he is immortal. And there was a lot of myth about this character. Some people say that this is the real Yeti. Some people say that, yeah, Ashwatthama actually, till date, he is alive. And probably he will come back. And some people say that, you know what, if you go to Angkor Wat temple, this is the gentleman who actually told the whole Mahabharata stories. And that's how you get all those kind of sculptures in that temple. Now, what we did, why we are different, what happened in that time? I personally digged into two different aspects of Indian mythology. One aspect was exploring, is it a real character? Well, yes. In Dehradun, if you explore, you can find a temple with his name. And till date, you will find there is a myth that till date, people say that within that temple, there used to be a drop of milk. And each and every night, he comes and probably drink it, because Ashwatthama used to love milk like anything. We explored that this gentleman probably traveled towards Himalayas, and yes, and he crossed Himalayas, went towards few part of the Asia. Then I lost the track. It was really hard. It's not that easy. And yes, we started exploring Indian fighting style, which is Kalaripayattu. So when you look at this kind of game, when you look at this kind of structure, you need to understand two different things, or probably three different things. One, are you making a normal 3D character, or you are doing something different? And if you're doing something different, why people will play this game? What is the outcome of it? Who will be your potential customer? The third point, how will you make money? So the way we did it is completely different. The way we did it is we made the game on a PC platform, created a complete CD out of it, went towards the market, talked to the people, and told them that, you know what? You are probably doing CD piracy, but this is a new game in the market. I'm going to give you the full subscription for 50% profit ratio. Whatever sale you do, I need a 50% balance out of it. People love the game. it became real hit. And we understood that, okay, fine, we can remodify, remold all these characters, which is there as a mythology. So what we did, we started converting characters. So if you look at these people, I'll show them. These are all, maximum of them are all from real actor and actress. Real, I mean to say, they exist in either in Tollywood or in Bollywood or in Hollywood. So this is a lady, I'm going to show you this one. She's right now a serial actress, and this is a gentleman from Russia who is practically a celebrity. But if you look at the characters, this is Mahishasur, this is Kumbhakarna, and these characters have got their own kind of name and meaning. The reason I'm showing you, because I'm going to show you a few bit of our works and why we are different, and then go back to the actual technology and probably share a few bit of other things. If you look at Indian mythology, this is how in old generation, in southern part of India, people used to dress up. And in our game, we call them as AVC. And this is one character, we call them as Urushiyam. So when you look at this gaming series called Fight of the Legend, you will find all these people with real-time, real-life socio-ecological culture. How? I'm not sure whether this is visible to you or not. If you look at these characters, this is Priya. We converted her into this kind of character. Now, this is Ina, converted her as a Devi, as one of the characters in one of our fighting game in probably Bangalore, they call it. This is Supriya, Mitra, who we converted them into a 3D character. So each and every character that you are watching on the screen are actually taken from real actor and actress. Now, these people actually acted in this game. We did 360 degree simulation. It was not easy. Trust me, it's not that easy. And we started creating Indianized comics for the Western world. If you look at these characters and the stylization, probably you can say that it doesn't look like the old dhoti kurta pajama type Indian character. No, it is not. We wanted to give a very different kind of look so that people connect and touch from the Western world. I'll tell you what happened after that. I'll show you a few of the shots. And then this is what happened during our journey. We had a discussion with Mr. Mukesh Khanna. He was probably India's first superhero. I'm not sure whether you have watched the TV series called Shaktiman or not. In my childhood days, I used to watch that. And I thought that why don't we convert Shaktiman as Shaktiman character in a 3D game? So I approached Mr. Khanna and he said that, okay, fine. I'll be more than happy to be a character into your game, but I became old. How will you convert me the way I used to look in that probably 20 years old TV serial? I became completely different. So it was really a hard challenge for us to convert him from old age to the way we made him. Now, these are all technical documentation. These are all new technologies that we did. So I can show you multiple number of examples that we did so far in movie industry. So this is few of the characters from Calcutta Tollywood movie industry. So this is Jeet, one of the superstar over here. This is Priyanka. I keep forgetting names, but if you are a media student, I think this slide will probably help you out. This is a breakdown of one of the character that we did for one movie. It's a crime thriller movie, basically. And we converted characters like this. So this is the way we take picture of one actor or actress. For the sake of presentation, I'm not showing the total 360 degree picture, but when you have a 360 degree picture of any gentleman, we convert them into our patented technology, and then we convert that into 3D polygon. And then after that, we do the sculpting and of course the colorization and the rigging, and then the coding happens. Few of the, I'll skip few of the parts of it, but rather I'll show something which is really cool, which probably nobody is doing. And we are probably the first adapter of this technology. This is called cosplay. I'm sure that you have been to a lot of cosplay shows in probably Bangalore, in Delhi, in Mumbai. But this is what you do. Whatever superheroes we have created inside the game, we converted their dresses, their elements, their toys into real dress, real toy, and real elements. So what happens when you play the game? You have an opportunity to buy these dresses from real store, and that gives you an edge. That gives you an opportunity to interact with real world. And guess what? How we are doing it? We are not fashion designer. We are not a fashion designing company. So what we did, we connected a lot of villages who are, who are basically from very humble background, don't earn that much, don't have proper education, but they have skill set. They know how to do knitting. They have a basic level of understanding how to do handicrafts. Mm-hmm. Few people can do few bit of pickles. What we did, we went to these kind of villages. We had a deep discussion with the local women group. And we said, you know what? We are going to teach you how to knit and how to do real fashionable dress. But these dresses are from our superhero characters. We are going to export all these dresses to few parts of the world. Wherever our players are, they have an option to buy these dresses, to buy these toys. And in return, whatever money we are generating, we'll be giving it to you for the development of your village. If you remember my life story, I wanted to make a disruption in the world. I wanted to make a little bit of change in our country. And I wanted to give some kind of comfort zone. And I felt that instead of giving a charity, if I can uplift these kind of people who are ready to learn and who are ready to earn, I think that's one of the best way. They will become self-sufficient. Guess what happened? Money-wise, they used to earn less than a dollar in a day. Family income. Nowadays, they are earning approximate $30 to $35 per day as a family income, just by working with us on cosplay and on creating stuffs like this. So I forgot the year, honestly speaking. We floated India's first e-commerce portal called cosplayseller.com. Why first? Because nobody ever tried to do that, ever dared to do that. We became successful. Although my market is not in India, I'm not going to get any kind of delivery in India. India is not ready yet for such kind of products. But if you look at the Korean market, if you look at the Chinese market, if you look at the Japanese market, Taiwan market, mainly in Asia, people are crazy about it. People usually go and buy. They love somehow our Indianized Western mode characters, and they love the storyline. And we didn't stop over there. What we did, we moved into real-time fashion. So when we started that journey of cosplay, eventually from all these actor, actress, they started saying that, why don't we move into the real-time, real-mode fashion community? That's bigger market. Could you please do something like this? We started hand-holding with international partners. We started communicating with people who can actually help to make it as a sizable market instead of only a superhero costume. So the way all these dresses are done, it's pretty interesting. You can actually remove few part of these dress, it becomes a superhero costume. You add few part of within these days dresses, it becomes a fashionable garment. So in a way, you have an option to probably enjoy both part of it. If you want to become a superhero, remove some parts. If you really want to make it happen as a fashionable garment, you just add few elements, it becomes a fashionable garment. I want to show you this slide. This is how I personally travel. This is how I personally talk to these very humble background people. They are really gem. Like, I'm just nothing, to be very honest. They are gem. They understand things, they portray things, and then they create it. And I love being with all these kind of guys. So thank you for the lovely introduction that you said that I traveled 34 countries. Actually, I traveled around 38. Probably I didn't update that. The reason I actually travel is like business travels, of course, multiple times in multiple places. When you travel, when you mix with people, you get to know about their culture. I'm not sure how many of you really explored that opportunity. If you look at Asia, if you look at probably the part of, say, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia, that part, Philippines Island, if you look at their food culture, you will get to know a lot of things. Why they eat such kind of food? Why they have a main course like that? What kind of fruits they have? What kind of gods they have? How they are impressed by Hinduism, Sindhism, probably the culture of ours? Why they have adopted such kind of colors? Now, when you go deep, you have a very basic level of market study. When you talk to the people who are from their universities, when you talk to their probably management level people, when you talk to their VCs, when you talk to their professors, you will understand that they have an inclineness to do something which is really cool, which is market connected. And somehow they felt that this mad person can probably do something good. So they took me on board and say that, hey, you know what? You can probably change some of our syllabus, probably add some tweak into it, and we can do something great together. So what we did, why this slide? While creating the normal usual VR game, I started converting their old syllabus into a new generation syllabus. What happened? The latest generation coders, they started teaching in these colleges. The latest generation animators, they started giving lecture into these colleges, and these people started getting all these value addition. And while doing teaching, we started giving outsourcing work to their students as an intern. So it became an ecosystem, and it became so big that in Facebook, we have got approximate, I think I forgot, probably 2.3 lakhs of students who are there in the group. Now it is in an automated way, like it's a pure student-run body. They get their own work, they give their own work, they earn their own money. And I'm really honored and blessed that all these guys, they are practically giving back to the community. And that's the essence of it. When I travel to Europe, there are number of entrepreneurs who have earned good number of money. Trust me, great number of money. All of them wanted to give back, but they say that, what is the way? We don't want to give our hard-earned money to some charitable organization. We want to make it as a sustainable model. So we started exploring all those kind of opportunities. If time permits, probably I'll take one example. Long back in 2006, when I was mentoring in the government of West Bengal, and that was a cluster development program for them, one lady came and she said that, sir, I am doing dry flowers. I don't know how to probably start a business. I'm an 8th standard pass out student. I don't have any kind of idea how to speak in English, but I am on my own trying to run my own venture with my mom. I want to scale up. Could you please help me? Now, probably as a student, you feel that this is really easy, like selling dry flowers, making it, sustaining in a family. It's not. Trust me, it's not that easy. And it's not that it's a need. It's not that in your home, you really, really need dry flowers. It's not a need. Now, it can be that, okay, fine, I need some decoration, I'm buying it. And if you are making it inside India, there is a challenge of quality. So I asked that lady that, could you please come out with one fashionable garment made with dry flower? And can you make an umbrella made with dry flowers? She said, yeah, I can do. So I gave her a month time. It was hard for her. Just imagine a lady without English power, without any technology. She don't know how to surf internet. She used to take help from probably some local shop owners. She just, you know, out of courage, she just said yes to me, but she did it. So after 1.5 months, she was there in front of me with one umbrella, with one fashionable garment, with all those dry flowers. It was a beautiful dress. And she said, now what? You asked me to do this, this is done. I said, hold on, let me do something for you. So I had a chat with a few of the people from Greece who are actually buyers of umbrellas from India. I told them, hey guys, you know what? There is a lady, this is her product, and it was happening in front of her, okay? Using a normal, usual call. And this is her product. And I think you're buying it for $8 from India. You can buy the same from her, but I'm going to give you a very different kind of business proposition. Whatever you're buying from her, you sell it with your own cost. We don't mind on that. But you ask your tourists to give it back to you with a 50% reduced cost. You resell it again and give 30% to this lady again. That gives you a different kind of business model. And of course, that clicked like anything. The lady right now is running approximate 300 plus employee strength company based out of Calcutta, and she's happy. So if you really want to do something, if you really want to disrupt the world, think on an innovative way. You don't have to reinvent the whole wheel, okay? You can always start a new productization for the world. Now the screen that you're watching, all these VR games, people can say that we are making VR, we have some kind of, you know, mobile, which we insert as a, probably a small mobile inside a VR glass, and that's VR. I'm really sorry, that's not VR. So I went to VR since 2006. I really feel pity when people say that in website, they are giving VR experience. In website, you are giving 360 degree experience, not VR. That's a website module that you're using, okay? Now, when you talk about VR, you have a headset or you have probably a glass like this, and it gives you an enhanced opportunity to interact with the objects inside 3D. That's called a VR. Until or unless you are interacting, it can be a movie, doesn't matter. It can be a game, it can be an application, but it has to be an interactive mode. It has to be completely inside that system. Until or unless it is there, it's very difficult. Because it's a presentation, I am not showing any kind of videos, but if you have inclinedness, it is there in the website. I'll share you the URL. You can cross-check how VR works, how 3D works. Probably that will give you a different bit of understanding. Now, when you talk about Indranai's character, I'm not sure whether you have heard about this young lady from Ramayana called Surpanakha. People used to call her as Demon Prince, Princess, I'm so sorry. People used to say that she was ugly and her nose was chopped by Lakshman. But I'm sorry, she was really beautiful. She was like beautiful like anything. So what we did as a concept, we converted that character with due respect to all those mythological characters. The name is Surpanakha, the storyline is different, but we made her very beautiful. And of course, this game is coming up very soon. But the fun part is, we are now connecting with tattoo designers as well. So not only dresses, if you look at the dress is there, but we are converting all these known tattoo designers in our network and asking them to create tattoos, especially for Surpanakha game. So when it will be released with our marketing strategy, mainly in US, Europe, and Asia, all these tattoo designers will have a flexibility to have all these consumers, all these gamers, who will come to them and ask them probably to go for a tattoo design. This is how you can probably create a market for the better world. So we jumped into the real movie industry as well. So let me go back to history. Let me tell you what happened to me when I tried to explore the movie industry. You saw that we converted 250 plus actor, actress, we converted people, they are celebrities. We took a lot of celebrities as a actor, actress. But when I tried to explore the movie industry, I forgot probably 2000, 2001, I was talking to a lot of directors trying to get a simple appointment of them, trying to tell them, hey guys, we are there for virtual reality, we are there for VFX, we are there for gaming. Probably I was too early for the market. And they said, hey, Arijit, this is fine, but I think we're not ready. I think this is not the market that we're looking for. So when we made a little bit of money, we give them an opportunity to come to us and tell them, okay, you are popular probably in your local community. Probably you are a celebrity in Calcutta. Probably you are a great actor in Mumbai. But here is the global market. We have got 25 million user base, and we are going to make you popular worldwide, not only inside one city or one country. And it's a shock for them. They said, oh my God, who is this guy? He's saying that I am a celebrity and he is going to make me more popular. Not gonna happen. But somehow, when there is a will, there is a way. People started believing us. We started taking a lot of people on board. For an example, Urvashi, Sunny Leone, lot of those actor and actress, like they started getting results and they practically became popular in the gaming world. And of course their fan base increased like anything. So that's one of the slide I thought that probably will be sharing. We co-invested into 7 different movies till date, which is pretty old. I think we did that. Last one we did probably in 2017, as per my memory goes. So when you do some good works, you get some kind of press releases. People usually have inclinedness to do your news. So yes, that happened. Keep happening. So these are the few of the companies that I run, co-invested, created platforms. Virtual Infocom, of course, the mother company, which is mainly into technology, high-tech technologies, mainly into gaming, animation, VR, AR, blockchain, IoT. Second Life Tech mainly works on virtuality solutions on health tech. For an example, if on a real-time basis, if a doctor can, if a doctor wish to do a pre-surgery of a patient, Second Life Tech gives a technology wherein you can do a pre-surgery before you do the actual surgery. It's not science fiction, it's happening. Animation Reviews is a platform wherein we usually write any kind of animated movie that is coming up in the market. We tie up with them, we create a press release for them. And of course they get a cross vice versa popularity. Cybersecurity is basically a byproduct. We have been hacked while there was an India-Pakistan cricket match happening because one of our very popular game was there in the market. And somehow those people thought that probably they can hack our website and do something nonsense. So I started exploring that market and somehow we started exploring the cybersecurity market. We started creating our own product which can protect your data and which can protect your structure. And that's how cybersecurity gig took birth. Right now we are a white label partner of a lot of MNCs, giving them security solutions. Probably if you are using few of the Android phones, you are actually using our product. Now, World Leader was actually 120 global speakers, 90 plus countries event, and that became a platform. And I'm really blessed that in the first year, we got mind-blowing response from people and we created the platform continuing the same. Of course, we got a lot of people from Parliament who are right now supporting us. Probably I can talk later on if required. That is there in the social media. You can cross-check and explore. My Films is a latest generation technology filmmaking company. So we don't produce movies, rather we create solutions for movies. For an example, if you really want to do probably a long shot using a drone, or probably you want to do underwater shots, we are there for any kind of technology solution that you need. We create plugins for your software, probably if you're using, maybe if you're using some kind of third-party software, we are there to create a solution for you, optimize your rendering, optimizing probably your workload, such kind of stuff. Anim Gaming is a platform wherein if you are an indie developer, if you are an indie game developer or indie filmmaker, you can upload your documentation, your creation over there. We find a publisher for you, sell it for you, and of course take a decent amount of percentage from there. Money making is good. Glam World Face is a platform basically for actor, actress, model, photographer, designers. You come, you register over here. We have a large pool of work. We outsource the work, and we usually go on a decent 2 years contract with you. So I can go on. Like, these are all great stuff. So Avalu Global is a investment banking company based out of Australia, started by me and two of my partners. We raise fund for startups. We raise fund for SMEs and corporates. Entrepreneur Phase, that's a platform basically based out of India. 6 years back, we started that. It's working in the same domain, collaborated with multiple number of legends, giants, the world, of course, raised money. I think I'm taking a lot of time. There are chat coming up. Let me, okay, no, this is attendance one. Okay. Let me end my slideshow. Before I end, these are my contact. If you really wish, you can take a snapshot. Pretty active in social media. You can probably connect with me. And yes, I always say that entrepreneurship is basically riding tiger. When you're riding it, you just can't stop. You need to keep riding it, and you need to feed it. And when you feed it, you need meat. And that meat is your money. And if you don't earn it, it's going to kill you. And if you overfeed it, it will become fat. It can't run. So it's an art and a science combination. And if you remember, I was talking about mad and madness. Mad for me, moderate, accurate, and determined. Thank you so much for listening to me.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Undoubtedly, an attention-grabbing lecture, interesting lecture. You have motivated students as far as the reality or the present scenario is concerned regarding the virtual reality, gaming, animation, and all. Thank you so much. Now I request Professor Dr. Amree Saxena, Dean DME Media School and Director of Studios and Production at DME, to please address the gathering and also deliver the vote of thanks for the guest of the session. Thank
you. Before we do that, ma'am, can I add a few bit of things?
Yes, sir, please.
Thank you. I'm sure that probably I'm addressing media students and management students, and you have a legal department as well. So in today's world, see, I was actually doing my marketing. I'm not giving any kind of motivational speech, to be very honest. Okay. I was sharing what all we are doing. Now, if you really want to build your career, in today's world, Patent Act, registering your, probably your creation, protecting your data, protecting your own creation is really important. And if you are a media student, you feel that I have some movie idea, probably I have created some kind of creation, I don't know how to protect it. I would love to give all of you guys simple tips, which I have learned so far from the market. Please remember, I'm not a lawyer. I'm just trying to help you guys, whatever I have learned so far. I have my legal team who are actually taking care of stuff. So if you have a code, or probably if you have some amount of creation, maybe a character, it can be some kind of unique stuff that you have done so far. Take a printout and then go to the normal post office, not a courier service, and ask the postmaster to give a stamp on the particular paper, and then post it probably to your one of your friend's house. It can be your friend, it can be your probably some different place, but it has to travel for minimum 8 working days. And that's the reason you go for post office. Okay. And then you ask that gentleman to repost it to your house. And then it will travel back again 8 days or probably 7 to 8 days. And with those steps, it gives you a basic protection. The reason I'm sharing you this, in today's world, law, marketing, technology, everything is becoming same. I would love to share you one story which is coming up. Probably you will see that in future. Trust me, I don't talk science fiction. I execute it. You see my glass, right? This is a normal glass. In future, all these glasses will be converted as an augmented reality glass. You just need to put a simple chip over here. Okay? This glass will convert as an AR glass. And in AR, it can actually detect your health. It can actually understand whether you are hungry or not. That's called AI. AI is not taking data from database. AI is basically a machine which is intelligent enough to understand your sequence from probably some global database, doesn't matter. Now, this AR glass understands your health and it understands whether you are hungry or not. Say for an example, 2 o'clock, you usually have your food. And at that particular moment, you're driving a car and your both the hands are on the steering, okay? And the glass knows that you are hungry and you need some amount of paneer tikka. So the glass will ask you, are you hungry? And you say yes. And it will ask you that, shall I order your favorite paneer tikka in nearby store? You blink your eyes, it means yes, or you say yes on your voice. And the order is done. So when you are there on that particular restaurant, you can have an option to eat on the spot or probably take it, right? What happened? You didn't pay anything, right? What happened to the payment mechanism? You didn't swipe your card. What happened in the back end? So in technology, there is a new technology that is coming up, which is more enhanced than blockchain. It is directly connected with your banking system. Your retina is already scanned with this glass. So authentication is done. And in your banking system, the payment gateway gives payment to that particular restaurant. When you are there, your payment is already done. And after you have the food, there is a mechanism whether you are satisfied or not. So it depends on your flesh and your eyes and your smile. Depending on that, the rating system will go from your AR glass to the centralized database system. And if you're not satisfied, it will give a response to the restaurant that, hey, my customer is not totally happy. I think you should enhance your food quality. And that particular system will again go back to the food inspector if there is any kind of glitch that's happening. That's coming, my guys, you know. So if you're a student, if you feel things are there in Google and you can find it, you're wrong. There are certain things which is there in the industry. You really need to connect, enhance, understand, talk to your teachers, understand what is going on. These things are called knowledge and wisdom. Whatever you're getting, you're actually getting information. Try to extract knowledge and wisdom. It's not easy for a student to go towards wisdom, but probably knowledge level, at least. I know that it's really, you know, sounds funny. As a student, you feel that, oh my God, I know everything. You know, I have the power of a smartphone and I can search, I can learn, I can understand. With all due respect, AI and smartphone is created by human being. There are multiple number of glitch. Try to get it from real human. I'm sorry for an interruption, but I thought that probably I should give this message to the youngsters. I'm really sorry if I you know, interrupted in between the...
No, sir, nothing like that. But there is one question. It is my personal question that how can we save ourselves from that level of artificial intelligence?
You want to save?
If it is so...
But why you want to save yourself?
No. That's what I'm asking. Maybe there is a little bit of confusion in my mind. That is it dangerous or is it really a technological advancement? What if the person is not that much technologically advanced or he or she is not able to use the technology in a very wise manner, that might be a kind of unsafe environment with those artificial intelligence glasses? This is my question, and this is a just a vague idea. Maybe shayad jo pehnungi artificial intelligence wale glasses, that then I will come to know that it may be a advanced stage of technology.
No, it's nothing like that. To be very honest, I don't want to do this, but the fact is, if you're not even online, if you're using a smartphone, even though the data is going on, okay, so you just can't hide from the latest generation technology. Very difficult, number one. Number two, we as Sindhu people, I don't call it as any kind of regional stuff. We as Sindhu people, we used to use the biggest technology, and probably we started forgetting that. Don't you feel in those so-called old times, we used to have test tube babies? We used to have technology where we never ever used to use any kind of external elements for any kind of medical treatment. It used to happen from neuron to neuron. It used to happen using your own hands. And that's what I call technology. I don't call technology as a gadget. Gadget is a byproduct. Now, coming back to your question, can you really safeguard yourself? 100% you can safeguard yourself. Now, there are certain things which probably you can control. For an example, forget that AR glass, forget that AI glass. Let's come back to our normal smartphone. Usually, maximum of us turn on our Wi-Fi. Don't turn it off, okay, in a public place. That's risky. Number two, we usually turn on our location unknowingly. We don't know how to control that. If you're doing that, of course, anybody can track you. There is a security problem that may happen. Now, when you're using your email, usually we don't see from which mail ID I'm getting that mail. We don't cross-check that URL. Before you send any kind of reply to any of the unknown email which is coming into your mailbox, may not be in a spam box, may not be in a promotion box, maybe in a normal box, cross-check the domain from maybe some other number. So there are certain number of security things which probably we can follow, which can protect us. Not only that, talking about passwords, how many of us use a great combination of passwords? You know, like probably 16 different characters with a combination of alphanumeric numbers. It's pretty easy to use. Probably you can replace your T with plus. We don't do that. Probably you can use 0 with O. We don't do that. Probably you can convert that A with @. We don't do that. These are very simple, basic measures. These are pretty basic. Nothing to fear, ma'am. I mean, if you really don't want to use that AR glass, that's perfectly fine. But the situation will be such, you have to use that. There is no other alternative way. It actually saves life. You're not taking any kind of call while you're driving, okay? You're not using any Bluetooth device. You're just talking with using your hands on the steering. So less chance of probably accident. Is it a satisfactory answer?
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Okay. So, Mr. Arijit, there's no question as such, but I want to request you to at least, because the session was obviously very informative and very foresightful, but then since this whole session is being attended by the students who have just joined journalism and mass communication course and the media, this management course. So what will you give them, any piece of advice, what all they should keep in mind while they will be studying for the next 3 years in media, in management, if you can precisely tell them something?
Okay, so for journalism students, try to explore deepfake. That's gonna be rocking like anything. Deepfake, I don't know whether you know it or not. Try to Google it, and then probably I'll, if time permits, I'll probably come again, try to give you some insights. For journalism, try to understand SEO perspective. Try to understand how to write content from the SEO perspective. It's not the writing that you need to do. You need to write on particularly how to optimize the website. The next generation technology that is coming up is called voice tagging. If you are a journalist, try to learn and understand what is voice tagging. Okay, I'll try to make it simple for all of you. Say, say for an example, I'm doing a YouTube video live, and I'm saying that the red colored scarf, I really loved it. And in Noida, I can see probably there are multiple stores who can offer me such kind of red scarf, and it's priced really, really low. The voice tagging system works on red scarf. It picks up that particular data. Now, whenever you are delivering any kind of lecture, any kind of talk, as a journalist, please try to understand what are the keywords. Try to grab that, get that. In future, if you're trying to do something on media and entertainment, it's totally combination with your editing software. I'm not sure which editing software you're going to use, but of course there are Black Witch, which is going to rock in near future. That's one example I can give you. Avid Studio, of course, is one of the best. Probably you can use that. There are certain amount of VFX software, which I feel you should explore. And the best possible way to do editing is get a camera, get a normal, very simple DSLR in your hand. Try to do shooting, try to probably work on few bit of colors, few bit of objects, work on lights. See, if you really want great job, or probably you, if you want to start your own venture, you need to be unique enough. Now, to become unique, there is certain little small process. Either you become a great sculpting artist, or probably you become a great photographer. Both got different demands. Don't try to do everything in life initially. Try to become master of a certain thing and then probably explore the second one. Now, kindly don't ask anyone that which one is better. Sculpting artist is better or photographer is better. Now, I will ask you a very silly question. Biryani is better or fried rice is better? It depends on the test. If you feel you are an artist, you are good in art, I can probably share you a couple of more things. You got amazing power, student community. And if you feel that you are an artist, create a very simple website. Try to ask people, probably from your community, to create more and more arts, which can probably be printed on dresses, maybe mugs, maybe gift items. Don't try to create an art just for the sake of art, with due respect to all the artists. Even I'm an artist by heart, until date I draw, okay? But if you want to sell your art, for an example, a wild painting, that will take a lot of time. Instead of that, create a design which can be printed into maybe a t-shirt, maybe a graffiti, it can be on mug, that sells better, okay? And I'm sorry, Ambarish ji, aapne kuch aur bhi aapka wo bataya
tha. Management ke liye aaya
sir. Management, yes. Now for management, it's gonna be really tough, to be very honest. It's not that smooth thing that you're going to face. For marketing, you need to understand the technology as well as people mindset. I can give you a small tip. Try to learn neuromarketing. That's one of the finest way probably you can grab people mind. And read a lot about which country, which location, which people, what they want, what kind of colors they wish for, what is your customer, and who is going to be your probably targeted consumer. Okay, live example. If I really want to sell my cosplay items, my customers are not kids. My customers are parents. Okay, for an example. Now, if you have something cool which you want to offer, for an example, you say that, sir, I am very good in social media marketing. I can do amazing stuff. Now, here is the tips for you. I'm sure you are using your Facebook. I'm sure you are using your Twitter. I'm sure you are using your Instagram. Instagram is more popular in young kids. I'm sure you have got thousands of followers. But when you try to join a company, at least we will cross-check your social media handles. What kind of post you have done so far in last 1 year? what kind of engagement levels that you have so far. So try to be very, very specific about your post. Each and every week, try to write something which is meaningful, post it in your social media channel. I'm not sure how many of you are using LinkedIn as your career path. That's one of the best way. Instead of Instagram, go for LinkedIn. Create a proper profile.
You know, I mean, I can tell you this. We have made this mandatory for all our students to have the LinkedIn account.
Super, super. And try to comment. Try to at least get in touch with your desired industry people. Sometimes they don't accept your request because LinkedIn is not like Facebook. It's not a, you know, friend request kind of stuff. When you send a request to anyone, give a note why you want to connect that gentleman or the woman. Try to go for keyword specific search in LinkedIn and join different groups and pages. Write your comments. For management guys, this is really, really important. When you probably, when say for example, if I want to hire some social media manager, he or she don't have at least 10,000 LinkedIn connection, which is meaningful, it's no point for me to hire that gentleman. I mean, it's just no point if they are using it just for fun. Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter. These are the four channels that probably you know. Try to explore VK. Try to explore Twitch. Twitch is another great platform. If you are probably really want to explore the marketing world with a little bit of fun, I think Twitch is one of the best way. VK is more popular in Russian segment, but it is more popular in Baltic belt as well. Now, what happens when you connect that VK with your LinkedIn profile? It gives you another level of enhancement. It's applicable for anyone, like management students, probably media students, everyone, journalists, everyone. And I'll highly recommend for your students, maybe if they are first year students, create small groups, maybe 5 people group, maybe 6 people group. Okay. Come up with your own idea, maybe a content, maybe a drawing. Okay. And do hackathon inside the college. Right. Forget about the prize money. Forget about what you're getting, but create a great community. And those communities can become really big in social media. When you have a big community, people usually listen to you.
Right. So it was really, very insightful session and a bit unconventional, which in fact I was looking for, because ultimately students are always in a conventional mode, though this corona has changed a lot as far as the delivery is concerned. But normally when we talk about the classroom teaching, and the same classroom teaching has been converted to online teaching, but teachers are teachers, so they teach in their own way. But then I always wished that when the students are entering into this whole professional course for 3 years, this bachelor's degree in journalism and mass communication and management studies, they need to be told the importance of certain such things, which are always useful, whether we talk about the entrepreneurship, whether we talk about the innovation, whether we talk about something which is futuristic and which is technology, because media is nothing else but all about technology. All advancement in media has happened as the technological advancement have been happening, and not only in the recent past, but it has been happening for the last 300 years since the time the advent of print media happened. It was all because of the printing technology that was available at a particular point of time. Accordingly, the publications and their format and their shape and everything decided. So we are living in a technological age. So obviously, anybody who is joining any such bachelor's degree must be well versed as to where the technology is and how the technology is to be used for their own betterment and for the betterment of the society. So I'm really thankful to Arijit Bhattacharya to spare time and to do this all for our students. Over to you, Manmeet.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Bhattacharya ji. Thank you so much. I request Professor Dr. Susmita Bala, Head DME Media School, to please share a few words.
Thank you, Manmeet. It was indeed an interesting and wonderful session. It was very informative. very useful on diverse subjects. Combination of innovation, animation, colors, and various aspects. Relevant for students, media students, and as well management students. I am sure students would have benefited a lot by this inspiring lecture. I express my gratitude to Mr. Adhijit Bhattacharya for igniting young minds. Thank you. I thanks all my faculty members and students for making this session a success. Thank you. Thank you to all of you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So this is all for today's orientation session by the keynote speaker, Mr. Arijit Bhattacharya ji. So I request all the students and the faculty members of DME Media School to please stay tuned in this Zoom room only. And we will be starting with the introduction of faculty as well as the PL session within 5 minutes. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Arjit.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. See you soon. Stay safe.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. If there are any DME management students, they can also leave the session. And they can join.
I think Manmi, they have already left because they had another session on other things.
Because they also have another PL session for their own department.
Yeah.
So let's start with today's PL session. So good afternoon, students. Thank you so much for joining us for the orientation session by Mr. Arijit Bhattacharya ji. And I know that you are the part of orientation program. Since yesterday, you were having sessions regarding the anti-ragging cell, then the keynote speaker for yesterday's session as well as for today's session. So this session is particularly for the DME Media School students as well as the DME faculty members. And in today's session, PL session, we will be discussing regarding the various aspects of DME Media School, the working of DME Media School, and various queries which I have been receiving. Maybe Mr. Pramod Kumar Pandey and Ms. Sukriti Arora is also receiving from your end regarding the coal poll issues and the joining of various societies, then the timetable and everything. So in today's session, I will be discussing each and everything point wise, one by one. And before that, I would like to introduce the faculty members of DME Media School so that you will come to know that how many members are there in DME Media School, which teacher is going to teach you in the coming semesters, in the first semester, who will be the mentors of the all the three sections of the first semester, who is the PL of the first year, everything we will be discussing in this session. So starting with the Dean, Professor Dr. Amreesh Saxena, I suppose sabko pata hai kyunki we have been in association and collaboration and connecting with each other since the days of SIFI, that is from 14th of December.
Since 11th, we had the first session.
Yes, we had 11. Two sessions before SIFI as well. But formally, you are connected with us in the middle of December. So Professor Dr. Amreesh Saxena, he is the Dean of the Department as well as Director of Studios and Production at Delhi Metropolitan Education. And sir has a vast experience in the media industry, in teaching, as well as he is an author, he is the editor, he is a theater artist as well. So I will share his brief profile with you, everyone. So let's go with the session because we are already moving ahead kyunki time bahut zyada ho chuka hai. So we need to leave the meeting by maximum by 3:40. So I will discuss each and everything in a very brief manner. So next we have head of the department, that is Professor Dr. Susmita Bala. So ma'am is the head of the department, and everything which you need to get signed, or maybe you need to get the permission regarding the university details, regarding the leave sanctions, regarding the participation in various extracurricular activities, inter as well as intra college activities, you need to get signed your documents by the head of the department. But for that you need to follow the hierarchy. Hierarchy means, first of all, you need to tell your mentors. then mentors will inform the program leader, and then program leader and mentors, whosoever is available that time, they will inform the head of the department. So students, you need to understand the hierarchy of the DME Media School, because there are so many incidents which will be coming in your way, that you need leave, you need permission for participation, you need so many things to get your enrollment number, to get your university admit card, to get your attendance status, everything. So you need to follow the hierarchy. So first of all, I would like to discuss बहुत सारी queries आई मेरे पास कि books और syllabus का क्या status है. चलिए पहले syllabus से start करते हैं. साथ के साथ हम DME Media School के जितने भी faculty members हैं उनका भी साथ के साथ introduction करेंगे. Pramod sir, are you there? I would like to know that has everybody joined the Zoom meeting room, DME faculty members?
एक second, मैं आपको बताता हूँ.
Yes, please inform.
Is on your camera.
हाँ, camera on कर लीजिए जो faculty members हैं.
Okay, we have Kamil sir, we have Mohit sir, we have Kritika ma'am. Sukriti ma'am is there. Okay, nice.
Sumantra sir शायद travel कर रहे हैं तो वो इसलिए.
हाँ, Krishna ma'am भी travel कर रहे हैं. Sumantra sir और Sanchita ma'am, उनका मुझे message आ गया था sir. I suppose Ritik sir is also not there, but we will introduce them one by one. So okay, so let's start with the mentors of section A, B and C of first year batch. Section A, I Manmeet Kaur will be the mentor of section A, and as well as the program leader for all the three sections, that is the first year batch 2020. So I welcome you all to the DME Media family. So ab apna jo bhi, keep your spirits high aur apne kaam ke liye, apni sincerity ko apne classes ke liye, so please be sincere, be regular in your classes, and be in healthy communication with all the faculty members. Theek hai? Then we have Mr. Pramod Kumar Pandey.
Good afternoon. I am Pramod Kumar Pandey, and I will be the mentor of Section C, and I'll be teaching communication theory with Section A and Section B. In addition to that, if I have to tell you about myself, I've been teaching since 2011. I did my master's in 2009 when Amrish Saxena sir was the one who set up the department, and I was part of the second batch at that point of time. And since then, I've been working under his supervision and guidance. In 2011, for about four and a half years, I was teaching in Muradabad, a university called Tirthankar Mahavir University. And then after that, for a very brief period of about 5 months, I guess, I was in WIPS, Pitampura. Then I left for my PhD. And then for 2 years, I was doing my PhD regularly. And then in 2018, I joined Delhi Metropolitan Education. So I've been here since 2018. But in addition to that, I've been doing, few other things simultaneously, like content writing at times and, some translation work at times. And I will be teaching communication theory to the two sections that I just mentioned. And I will be the mentor. So in case I've been getting a lot of queries and I've been trying to, answer most of them, but it's like, I get a lot of messages in a day. So I have been inefficient in dealing with every query that I'm getting. So, once the sections will be divided and you all will be under your respective mentors, I think the load of the queries that is coming on me and Manmeet ma'am will be divided. And then I think, we'll be able to better handle your queries and we'll be able to better address your concerns. Thank you very much. If there's any issue, you can let me know later.
Thank you so much, Pramod sir. Ms. Sukriti Arora. Sukriti ma'am.
Sukriti ma'am.
Pramod sir, unko unmute kijiye. Okay.
Thank you, Pramod sir. Thank you, Manmeet ma'am. Hello, everybody. I am Sukriti Arora, and I will be the mentor of Section B. So, and I will be teaching personality development to all three sections. Now, personality development is basically an elective subject. So some of you will be choosing writing skills. Some of you will choose personality development, whichever suits your taste. We will tell you all about it tomorrow when we formally start with the session and we start delivering our lecture. lectures. We'll tell you. So how it works is that A and B section will be skills and one section at the same time for personality development. And section C will have its own division between the two sections, but I will be taking both the entire batch for this particular subject for this semester. And my hope is that once you all start from tomorrow onwards, you will just, you know, be more participating in terms of everything that we try to do here, including the lectures and all the other extracurricular activities that happen here. To talk just a little bit about myself, there is not a long profile here. I did my graduation from Indraprastha College for Women, that is in Delhi University, as Bachelor in Mass Media and Mass Communication. And I've done my master's from Guru Jambeshwar University, Hisar. And I qualified NET after that. And I have worked as a content writer. I have worked as a ghostwriter for a novel. I have some experience as a consultant as well. And in 2019, it was my first teaching job at DME. I joined here in February 2019, and since then I have been here. I also take subjects of advertising, media laws and ethics, etc. in different semesters. So for now, it will be only personality development with your semester, and later on, let's see how we move forward and what other subjects do I get to teach you in the future. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sukriti ma'am. Next, we have Mr. Kamil. Pramod sir, unmute.
I have made him the co-host. Okay, I'll unmute him. Okay. Oh, you have muted yourself. Okay.
Muted.
Yeah, okay. Unka thoda.
Okay, fine. It's fine now.
Is it audible now?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Hello, I'm Mohammed Kamil, Assistant Professor at DME Media School. I am associated with DME Media School since 2018, and I will be taking the writing skills paper in this semester. Prior joining to DME Media School, I was working with Times of India. I had a brief, working there for like 3 years. Like after qualifying the NET examination, I joined DME Media School. As far as my graduation is concerned, I did it from Delhi University, and my master's is from Guru Jambeshwar University. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kamil sir. Next, we have Mr. Mohit Kishore Watts.
Thank you, Manmeet ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mohit Kishore Watts, and I am working as an assistant professor at DME Media School. Prior to joining DME, I was working as an assistant professor at Madhubala Institute of Communication and Electronic Media. And I've done my graduation in mass communication from GEMS. And then I completed my master's from Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, main campus. I and Pramod sir, we both are batchmates. And after that, I also worked for a brief period with the All India Radio. And at my tenure with All India Radio, I had worked with the sports section. So I was the active part of the production team, which had broadcasted many bilateral cricket series and the ICC Cricket World Cup 2011. Other than that, talking about the subject which I'll be taking up in this current semester, that would be Contemporary India, an overview. It's a kind of a subject which is primarily related to current affairs and the state of economy of India, plus the political affairs and the issues, plus history and culture. These are all things we have already studied in your school. We are going to discuss the basics right now in the coming classes, because as a journalist, I feel it's very, very important that we know about the history of our country, about the political setup, about the economy, and the issues which are concerning India. So that's about me. And talking about the interest area which I have interest in sports and current affairs. So we would be discussing that in our classes, and hope to see you in classes. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mohit sir. So next we have Ms. Kritika Sati.
Thank you, Manmeet ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Kritika, and I'll be taking up design and graphics with you. So A and B section, I'll be taking DNG and DNG lab. So design and graphics subject is all about designing and more about the concepts of typography and a lot of stuff we are going to discuss in this subject. So I'm not going to discuss much about that right now. So, and apart from that, if I tell about myself, I have also done my graduation in journalism and mass communication from IP University, like you guys are going to do now. And then I went on to do PG diploma in mass communication, then master's in mass communication. And I have been associated with DME since 2018. And before that, I was working in PR field. So that is also one of the subjects that I take, PR lab, in one of the semesters in this course. So I, apart from DNG, design and graphics, I take up print journalism, new media that you will be introduced in your subsequent semesters. So you'll be studying those subjects as well. So that's all about me. So we'll meet in the classes and we'll discuss about colors, designs, typography, and a lot of stuff. Be designing many things. So you'll be working on some softwares also. So it's going to be a fun subject. So I hope you all come in the classes and we'll learn a lot of stuff in the classes. Thank you.
Thank you, Kritika ma'am. Thank you so much. Next, we have Mr. Sachin Nair.
सचिन सर थे यहाँ पे, रुकिए मैं देखता हूँ,
कुछ कनेक्टिविटी इशू होगा.
ओके फाइन, ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं. इन द मीनवाइल सचिन सर जॉइन अस, तो तब तक हम थोड़ा सा डिस्कस कर लेते हैं रिगार्डिंग द टाइम टेबल एंड द सिलेबस.
इंट्रोडक्शन करवा दो बाय नेम.
अच्छा, ओके फाइन. मैंने सोचा था कि बीच में करवा दूंगी, थोड़ा सा मोनोटनी हो जाएगी सब चीजों को डिस्कस करते करते, तो देन आई विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द अदर टीचर्स. एनीवेज, ओके, मिस संचिता चक्रवर्ती इज आल्सो द पार्ट ऑफ डीएमई मीडिया स्कूल. शी इज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हियर एंड शी विल बी टेकिंग हेल्थ कम्युनिकेशन एज वेल एज डेवलपमेंट कम्युनिकेशन सब्जेक्ट्स इन द कमिंग सेकेंड सेमेस्टर एंड द थर्ड सेमेस्टर. देन वी ऑल्सो हैव मिस कृष्णा पांडे. Krishna ma'am is a senior faculty here and she has been associated with DME since 2019, and she will be taking up the media research subject, then public relations subjects in the fourth and the fifth semester respectively. Then we also have Mr. Ritik Ghosh. Mr. Ritik Ghosh is an assistant professor at Delhi Metropolitan Education DME Media School, and he is a social media expert. And he will be taking up the television production subject as well as RJNR subject in the third and the fourth semester. Then we have Mr. Sumantra Sarthi Das. He is also an assistant professor at DME Media School, and he is also the head. You can say that he is actually looking after all the processes and all the technicalities related to the working structure of the Studio 62 at DME. And he will be taking the subject related to video editing as well as other technical subjects in the coming third and the fourth semester, that is a television production subject. Then we also have Mr. Sachin Nair. He might be joining in few minutes, maybe it's due to some connectivity issue, he is not here with us. So he is also taking the subject related to photography as well as related to various production subject, and he will be teaching you regarding the technical subject in the coming semester, that is the second semester and the third and the fourth semester respectively. Then I will be taking up the communication concepts and processes in the first semester, print journalism in the second semester, and of course in the fifth semester media research and film appreciation subject. So this is all about DME Media School faculty members, if I'm not missing somebody. Miss Mudita is also the part of DME Media School, and most probably she will be taking up the contemporary issue subject in the first semester. So this is all about the DME Media School faculty members. Now coming to the classes, syllabus and books and timetable. So maybe by today evening, we will be sharing the timetable with you people through mail and WhatsApp group. Those who have not joined, the WhatsApp group for the shift one and shift two. I had already posted a message through email, a link to join the WhatsApp group. So if anybody has any issue with that, kindly mail either me, Pramod sir, or Sukriti ma'am. That is, we will be sharing our email IDs in the chat box very shortly. So if you have any problem in joining the WhatsApp group or in receiving the mails or messages, please do post or do message us so that we can rectify your problems accordingly. Then we have already shared the PDF file of syllabus in both the groups, that is shift one and shift two. So you go through with the syllabus. अभी तक आपने शायद सिलेबस पढ़ लिया होगा तो कल हम कामिल सर के साथ और सुकृति मैम के साथ एक स्पेशल सेशन करेंगे जो कि राइटिंग स्किल्स और पर्सनालिटी डेवलपमेंट के इलेक्टिव सब्जेक्ट के साथ रिलेटेड होगा. सुकृति मैम आपको पर्सनालिटी डेवलपमेंट के बारे में और कामिल सर आपको राइटिंग स्किल्स के बारे में थोड़ा और इंसाइटफुल लेक्चर प्रोवाइड करने की और उसका चॉइस बेस्ड जो भी आपके डिसीजंस हैं उनको थोड़ा सा और ज्यादा क्लियर करने की कोशिश करेंगे. सो यू ऑल ज्वाइन दिस सेशन. हम जल्दी आपके साथ सेशन का टाइम और सेशन का लिंक पोस्ट कर देंगे. सो कामिल सर और सुकृति मैम आपको हेल्प करेंगे कि किस तरीके से आपको इलेक्टिव सब्जेक्ट की चॉइस फिल करनी है. देन उसके बाद जो आपके बुक्स की क्वेरीज आई हैं अभी तक मेरे पास, शायद प्रमोद सर के पास भी आई हैं, आपको कोई भी बुक अभी नहीं खरीदनी. You don't have to buy the books. Maybe teachers will tell you one or two books, like do teen common books hoti hain jo all the 3 years, like 6 semesters, wo aapke liye helpful rehti hain. To wo aapko ek ya do books purchase karni hongi. Amazon par wo easily available hai. We will share the names, titles as well as the authors of the book so that you can purchase those books. They will be beneficial for the coming 6 semesters of your BA JMC course. Otherwise, teachers will provide you notes, teachers will provide you PPTs, they will give you lectures through PPTs, and all the books they are available in the library. कि जो भी बुक्स आपके पास, जो भी आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट है, आप लाइब्रेरी जब आपका कार्ड बन जाएगा, आप मेरी परमिशन से सुकृति मैम को इन्फॉर्म करके, प्रमोद सर को इन्फॉर्म करके, कोई एक दिन डिसाइड करके लाइब्रेरी में आ सकते हैं, अपनी बुक्स को इश्यू करवा सकते हैं. अब आती है बात कि लाइब्रेरी कार्ड कैसे बनेगा. We are expecting in another 15 days, we will be getting your enrollment numbers from the university. Now, what is enrollment number? Enrollment number, आपका 3 साल के लिए आपका एक identity number है, जो कि आपके university और college के साथ एक communication को ठीक करता है. आपकी university के जितने भी documents होंगे, say for example, detail marks card, आपका RC chart, आपका degree, और जितने भी आपके एडमिट कार्ड्स हो गए, जितने भी आपके यूनिवर्सिटी के डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैं, उसके ऊपर एनरोलमेंट नंबर लिखकर आएगा. यूनिवर्सिटी को नहीं पता कि आपकी अदरवाइज कौन सी आइडेंटिटी है. सो एनरोलमेंट नंबर इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट नंबर विच यू नीड टू लाइक ग्रैस्प. उसको रट्टा मार लो कि कैसे उसको यूज करना है आपने 3 साल के लिए. सो एनरोलमेंट नंबर के थ्रू आपको लाइब्रेरी का एडमिट कार्ड इशू होगा. लाइब्रेरी के एडमिट कार्ड के साथ आपको कॉलेज का आइडेंटिटी कार्ड इशू होगा, जिसके थ्रू आप कॉलेज और लाइब्रेरी को विजिट करेंगे. मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, वी डोंट नो कब हम फिजिकल क्लासेस शुरू कर पाएंगे. मे बी इन अनदर 3 or 4 months. जब भी आप कॉलेज विजिट करेंगे, आपका आइडेंटिटी कार्ड आपके साथ रहना चाहिए, अदरवाइज आपको कॉलेज में एंट्री नहीं मिलेगी. फोर मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, जिस तरीके से आप अपने बैग्स में वॉलेट्स डालते हैं, अपना फोन नहीं भूलते हैं, वैसे आपको अपना आइडेंटिटी कार्ड कॉलेज का नहीं भूलना, लाइब्रेरी कार्ड नहीं भूलना अपना. ओके, देन उसके बाद आती है हमारे पास अटेंडेंस की बात. As per the GGSIPU guidelines and rules and regulations, 75% of the attendance is mandatory. जो भी हमारे ग्रेजुएशन के स्टूडेंट्स हैं, सो इस अटेंडेंस को मेंटेन करने के लिए आपको रेगुलर क्लासेस लगानी है. जो भी ऑनलाइन मोड पर इस टाइम पर क्लासेस चलेंगी, सारी क्लासेस की अटेंडेंस कोल पोल पर फीड होगी और हम मैनुअल भी उस अटेंडेंस का पूरा रिकॉर्ड अपने साथ रखते हैं. देन इस अटेंडेंस को हम एंड ऑफ मंथ रिलीज करते हैं स्टूडेंट्स को बताने के लिए, और फर्स्ट सैटरडे ऑफ एवरी मंथ वी विल बी होल्डिंग अ पीटीएम विद योर पेरेंट्स. और इसीलिए आपको एक मैसेज भी जाएगा, आपके पेरेंट्स को फोन पर एक मैसेज जाएगा, मेल्स जाएंगी, सो दैट दे कैन अटेंड द पीटीएम. और इस टाइम पर हम वर्चुअल पीटीएम लेते हैं, तो हम जो वर्चुअल पीटीएम का लिंक है वो अपने स्टूडेंट्स के ग्रुप में और स्टूडेंट्स के साथ उसको शेयर करते हैं. और जितनी भी इंफॉर्मेशन आपको चाहिए प्लीज डीएमई का जो फेसबुक पेज है उसको फॉलो कीजिए और कॉलपॉल पर रेगुलरली विजिट कीजिए. अब कॉलपॉल के जो इश्यूज हैं, एज पर द कन्वीनर ऑफ द कॉलपॉल एट डीएमई, उन्होंने हमें ये इन्फॉर्म किया है कि जो भी आपकी जो प्रोफाइल्स हैं कॉलपॉल पर जो बनी है वो एक्टिवेट होंगी बाय 2nd of January. तब तक थोड़ा सा पेशेंस दिखाइए. अगर किसी ने ईमेल आईडी अपना चेंज करना है वो मुझे सुकृति मैम और प्रमोद सर को मेल कर दीजिए सो दैट हम इस केस को आगे फॉरवर्ड करें. अदरवाइज अगर आपको कॉलपॉल पे अभी कुछ भी चीज विजिबल नहीं है प्लीज थोड़ा सा पेशेंस के साथ काम लीजिए. कॉलपॉल पर आपको 2nd of January के बाद सारी चीजें विजिबल हो जाएंगी. अटेंडेंस, असाइनमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग द फीड्स, रिगार्डिंग द पोस्ट, रिगार्डिंग द इवेंट्स, विच एनी न्यूज विच इज रिलेटेड टू डीएमई मीडिया स्कूल एज वेल एज डीएमई, इट विल बी अवेलेबल ऑन द ERP पोर्टल ऑफ डीएमई. फाइन. देन उसके बाद हमारे पास आती है सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज, दैट इज द रजिस्ट्रेशन कार्ड. रजिस्ट्रेशन चार्ट्स आते हैं यूनिवर्सिटी से जो कि आपके जो सेमेस्टर के फाइनल एग्जाम्स होते हैं उससे पहले यूनिवर्सिटी रिलीज करती है और उन चार्ट्स पर स्टूडेंट्स को साइन करना होता है. जैसे ही आपके मेंटर के थ्रू आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन आएगी कि यूनिवर्सिटी का जो रजिस्ट्रेशन कार्ड है वो टीचर्स के पास है एंड यू नीड टू कम टू द कॉलेज एंड साइन योर RC चार्ट एज पर द इलेक्टिव चॉइस एज वेल एज द रेगुलर सब्जेक्ट, आपको उस दिन उस टाइम पर कॉलेज में आकर उस चार्ट को साइन करना है. अदरवाइज आपका एडमिट कार्ड फाइनल एग्जाम्स के लिए आपको नहीं मिलेगा. सो जो भी आपके उस टाइम पर प्रायोरिटीज होंगी, कमिटमेंट्स होंगी, उनको आपने अपने तरीके से हैंडल करना है, ऑल्टरनेटिव्स देखने हैं, देन उसके बाद उस रजिस्ट्रेशन कार्ड को आपने साइन करना है. अब कभी कभी क्या होता है कि किसी स्टूडेंट की कोई प्रॉब्लम है, बहुत कोई सीवियर प्रॉब्लम है, बीमार है, कुछ फैमिली प्रॉब्लम है, मिस हैपनिंग्स है, एनीथिंग कैन बी हैपन विद एनीबडी. सो प्लीज इन्फॉर्म योर मेंटर ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस. आप दो दिन से ज्यादा, अगर एक ही टाइम पर दो दिन से ज्यादा एबसेंट रह रहे हैं तो ये आपकी ड्यूटी है कि आप अपने मेंटर्स को इन्फॉर्म करेंगे कि आप 3rd day क्लास में क्यों नहीं आ पाए. अदरवाइज आपको जब 1st day भी आप छुट्टी ले रहे हैं, 1st day किसी रीजंस की वजह से आप क्लास में नहीं आ रहे हैं, द CRs विल बी द रिस्पॉन्सिबल कि उस टाइम पर किन स्टूडेंट्स को दो दिन से ज्यादा या एक दिन वो पूरे दिन क्यों नहीं आया क्लास में. ये सारी चीजें CRs अपने मेंटर्स को इन्फॉर्म करेंगे. बाय नेक्स्ट वीक मे बी फ्रॉम 4 January ऑनवर्ड्स हम CRs की जो एक्टिविटी है उस पर काम करेंगे. हम CRs को सिलेक्ट करेंगे, CRs को उनकी ड्यूटीज और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज असाइन की जाएंगी और CRs अपने मेंटर्स के साथ प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन के साथ अपनी ड्यूटीज को फुलफिल करेंगे. देन उसके बाद PTM अटेंड करना सबके लिए कंपलसरी है. PTM की पूरी इन्फॉर्मेशन कॉलपॉल और फेसबुक पर पोस्ट की जाती है, SMS पेरेंट्स के मोबाइल नंबर पर और जो भी आपके एडमिशन के टाइम रजिस्टर्ड नंबर्स हैं उन पर हम उनको पोस्ट करते हैं. देन प्रोजेक्ट्स, ऑफकोर्स जो भी टीचर आपको जो भी प्रोजेक्ट्स देंगे इन द फॉर्म ऑफ असाइनमेंट्स, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ योर लैब असाइनमेंट्स, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ योर फाइनल प्रोजेक्ट्स, यू नीड टू मेंटेन दैट पोर्टफोलियो इन अ वेरी प्रॉपर मैनर. क्योंकि फाइनल सेमेस्टर में जो सिक्स सेमेस्टर होता है फाइनल ईयर का, उसमें आपको एक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव फाइल बनानी होती है जिसके लिए आपको 1st semester ऑनवर्ड से जितने भी आपके सब्जेक्ट्स हैं और जितने भी आपने असाइनमेंट्स और प्रोजेक्ट्स किए हैं, यू नीड टू फीड ऑल दोज असाइनमेंट्स इन दैट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव फाइल. यू नीड टू टेक ऑल दोज असाइनमेंट्स, ऑल दोज प्रोजेक्ट्स इन दैट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव फाइल. सो इंटरनल एक्सटर्नल प्रैक्टिकल के दिन जब आपकी फाइल एक्सटर्नल एग्जामिनर रख लेते हैं, सो इट इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू सेव ऑल दीज फाइल्स इन अ PDF manner or maybe in a hard disk or maybe in your mail drive. This is your responsibility to store, to save all your projects in a proper manner with proper dates, with proper semesters, with proper detailing. So, उस टाइम पर ये ना हो कि कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव के टाइम पर भी नहीं. मुझे लगता है कि जब आप ग्रेजुएशन करके बाहर निकलेंगे जॉब्स के लिए भी, when your employer will ask you what you had done in the 3 years of your graduation, आपके पास कुछ तो होना चाहिए दिखाने के लिए कि आपने इन प्रोजेक्ट्स के ऊपर काम किया. सो दिस इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. टीचर्स आपके प्रोजेक्ट्स को PDF फाइल में या ड्राइव में उस तरीके से मेंटेन करके नहीं चलेंगे. आप खुद अपने प्रोजेक्ट्स के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल रहेंगे. यू आर ग्रोन अप नाउ. देन वी हैव इंटर्नशिप्स. इंटर्नशिप के लिए क्या होता है कि 1st year के बाद आपको प्रिंट जर्नलिज्म में कंपल्सरी इंटर्नशिप करनी है. देन आपको 2nd year के बाद इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया और PR रिलेशन कंपनी या फिर एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी में आपको इंटर्नशिप करनी है. देन उसके बाद आपको क्या करना है कि जो आप इंटर्नशिप किसी भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में जब आप करते हैं, आपको उसके लिए कॉलेज में आने के बाद एक 100 marks का पूरा हार्ड बाउंड में एक प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट रेडी करना होता है इन योर ओन वर्ड्स, इन योर ओन एक्सपीरियंस. और जो आपको कंपनी सर्टिफिकेट प्रोवाइड करेगी, उस सर्टिफिकेट को आपने अपने प्रोजेक्ट में उसको आपने साथ में लगाना है फॉर प्रॉपर ऑथेंटिकेशन, फॉर प्रॉपर क्रेडिबिलिटी ऑफ योर प्रोजेक्ट. सो दीज टू प्रोजेक्ट्स, दे आर ऑफ 100 marks. दे आर कंपल्सरी प्रोजेक्ट्स एज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द सिलेबस गिवन बाय GGSIP University फॉर BA/GMC कोर्स. एंड यू ऑल नीड टू अटेंड द इंटर्नशिप. कंपल्सरी इंटर्नशिप है जो आपको अटेंड करनी है. इंटर्नशिप के लिए क्या होता है कि जैसे अब नाउ द सिचुएशन इज ऑल टुगेदर अ डिफरेंट सिचुएशन. अदरवाइज क्या होता था कि जनवरी फरवरी तक स्टूडेंट्स के CVs हमारे पास आते थे, हम उन CVs को देखते थे और रिकमेंडेशन के लिए हम खुद डीन सर और HOD मैम खुद कंपनीज और जो प्रिंट मीडिया ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैं उनके रेफरेंसेस स्टूडेंट्स को वहां पर भेजते थे. नाउ मे बी In April or May, we will be collecting your CVs so that जब आप second semester खत्म करें तो हमारे पास आपका area of interest, आपका जो skill है, आपका जो कह लीजिए कि अगर writing में जाना चाहते हैं, photography में जाना चाहते हैं, उस तरीके से हम आपके skills के according आपको internship provide करने में आपकी help करें. Otherwise, if you have your own contacts, you can also get the internship as per your suitability, as per your convenience. Then सेकेंड ईयर में भी सेम आपको 4 semester के बाद पब्लिक रिलेशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन या फिर एडवर्टाइजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन या फिर आपको इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया से फॉर एग्जांपल टेलीविजन और रेडियो में आपको इंटर्नशिप करना है, विच इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड कंपल्सरी इंटर्नशिप कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ 100 marks मेजर प्रोजेक्ट. सो दिस इज दीज आर द 2 projects रिलेटेड टू इंटर्नशिप. नाउ द थर्ड मेजर प्रोजेक्ट इज आफ्टर द 5th semester, विच इज द मीडिया रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट. And then in the 6th semester, that is the final project and the comprehensive viva, which is the amalgamation of all the 3 years when you will be making some short film, some documentary, or maybe a major media research project as per your interest, as per your own skills. Then we have BG Varghese lecture series. हर महीने DME मीडिया स्कूल की तरफ से स्टूडेंट्स के इंटरेक्शन के लिए, स्टूडेंट्स को इंडस्ट्री एक्सपोजर के लिए DME मीडिया स्कूल BG वर्गीज लेक्चर सीरीज को कंडक्ट करते हैं, विच इज कंपल्सरी फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू टू ज्वाइन टू इंटरेक्ट विद द इंडस्ट्री एक्सपर्ट, टू गेट इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द प्रेजेंट सिनेरियो ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री, टू गेट द इंफॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ मीडिया इंडस्ट्री, फॉर वेरियस प्रोफेशंस रिलेटेड टू मीडिया इंडस्ट्री. ये इन सब चीज़ों के लिए BG वर्गीज लेक्चर सीरीज कंडक्ट की जाती है. और BG वर्गीज लेक्चर सीरीज की प्रॉपर इंफॉर्मेशन जो भी प्लेटफॉर्म है जहाँ पर हम करेंगे, प्रॉपर इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द एक्सपर्ट हु विल बी कमिंग फॉर द लेक्चर सीरीज, वी विल प्रोवाइड यू विद प्रायर इंफॉर्मेशन सो दैट कि एंड टर्म पर आपका कोई प्रॉब्लम ना हो या कोई एक्सक्यूज ना हो कि आप क्यों नहीं BG वर्गीज लेक्चर सीरीज को ज्वाइन कर पाए. ओके, देन वी विल हैव फोटो वॉक्स. सेकेंड सेमेस्टर में आपका जो मेजर सब्जेक्ट है दैट इज द फोटोग्राफी. और फोटो वॉक्स जो है वो फोटोग्राफी के सब्जेक्ट की असाइनमेंट्स और उसके प्रोजेक्ट्स के साथ रिलेटेड है. जितने भी अभी तक हमारे फोटो वॉक्स हुए हैं विद इन दिल्ली, फॉर एग्जांपल कुछ मॉन्यूमेंट्स या बर्ड सेंचुरी, हुमायूं टॉम, देन कुतुब मीनार, ऐसे कुछ ऐसे मॉन्यूमेंट्स हैं जो वन डे के बीच में आपके फोटो वॉक को कवर करेंगे सो दैट कि आपको इस तरीके से ना हो कि घर से कभी परमिशन मिलती है, नाइट स्टे के लिए नहीं मिलती. सो दीज आर द वेरी ब्रीफ फोटो वॉक्स जो आपको फोटोग्राफी के सब्जेक्ट के साथ एक प्रॉपर एक्सपोजर प्रोवाइड करेंगे, एक प्रॉपर कह सकते हैं कि थोड़ा नॉलेज प्रोवाइड करेंगे कि किस तरीके से आपको किन टेक्निकलिटीज के साथ अपनी जो फोटोग्राफी की असाइनमेंट्स हैं और उसके प्रोजेक्ट्स को आपने पूरा करना है. टीचर्स जो होते हैं फोटोग्राफी सब्जेक्ट को लेते हैं, दे विल अकंपनी विद यू एंड देन उनकी सुपरविजन के अंडर आप अपने प्रोजेक्ट्स को कंप्लीट करते हैं. देन वन कंपल्सरी फोटो वॉक, वैसे सब भी फोटो वॉक्स कंपल्सरी हैं. देन उसके बाद जो एक मेजर फोटो वॉक है जो शायद 6th semester के स्टूडेंट्स अपनी डॉक्यूमेंट्री मेकिंग में भी और रिसर्च में भी इंक्लूड करते हैं, दैट इज द सूरजकुंड फेयर which happened in the month of January or February, and because due to COVID maybe इस साल नहीं हो पाएगी in 2021, but we will find the alternatives so that कि किसी भी तरीके से आपके जो भी project हैं, जो भी आपके assignments हैं, वो किसी भी तरीके से hamper ना की जाए. So we are making alternatives. We are making alternative assignments for the students so that students ko proper exposure diya jaye, proper unka skill enhancement ho. Then uske baad sections. Yes, very important. इस टाइम पर हमने आपकी जो एडमिशन की सीरीज है उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमने सेक्शंस को डिवाइड कर दिया है. दैट इज सेक्शन ए बी एंड सी. फर्स्ट शिफ्ट इज कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ सेक्शन ए एंड बी एंड सेक्शन सी इज कंप्राइज्ड ऑफ द सेकंड शिफ्ट ऑफ डीएमई मीडिया स्कूल. अब जैसे ही हमारे पास एनरोलमेंट नंबर्स आएंगे यूनिवर्सिटी से, मे बी इन अनदर 15 और 20 डेज, आपके सेक्शंस हो सकता है 15-20 डेज, मैंने अपने तरीके से टाइम बताया है, इसलिए प्लीज 15-20 डेज के बाद पूछना मत शुरू करना कि एनरोलमेंट नंबर कब आएंगे. जैसे ही आएंगे आपको बता दिया जाएगा. ओके, सो प्लीज थोड़ा सा इस चीज को भी अवॉइड कीजिए कि बहुत ज्यादा पर्सनल मैसेजेस फैकल्टी मेंबर्स को मत कीजिए. आपने जो चीज कॉमन आपकी है आप ग्रुप पर पोस्ट कीजिए. जिस फैकल्टी मेंबर के पास उस क्वेरी का आंसर होगा या जो भी इवन डीन सर और हेड मैम भी उसी ग्रुप में है, जिसके पास जब उस क्वेरी का आंसर होगा वो आपको इमीडिएटली उस क्वेरी का आंसर दे देंगे. आई एम रिसीविंग एन नंबर ऑफ पर्सनल मैसेजेस ऑन माय व्हाट्सएप एंड समटाइम्स लेट इन द नाइट, जिसको मैं शायद सुबह या दोपहर तक उसको आंसर करना भी मेरे दिमाग से निकल जाएगा बिकॉज इतने सारे कंपाइलेशन हो जाते हैं मैसेज के और सिर्फ कॉमन क्वेरीज होती हैं. सो एक हैबिट ये डिवेलप करो कि अपनी क्लास के साथ भी हेल्दी कम्युनिकेशन को डिवेलप करो. मुझे पर्सनल मैसेज करके या ग्रुप से बिल्कुल चोरी से किसी और टीचर को मैसेज करके, इट विल जस्ट क्रिएट मिसकम्युनिकेशन. और मे बी ये भी हो सकता है कि आप जब हेल्दी कम्युनिकेशन में आपस में बात करेंगे तो उन सिचुएशंस की, उन प्रॉब्लम्स के अच्छे सॉल्यूशंस और अल्टरनेटिव्स निकल कर बाहर आएंगे. सो डिवेलप दिस हैबिट टू बी इन हेल्दी कम्युनिकेशन विद योर क्लासमेट्स. नाउ सेक्शन ए बी एंड सी, जब एनरोलमेंट नंबर्स आएंगे डेफिनेटली आपके सेक्शंस दोबारा से चेंज हो जाएंगे. सो इसलिए उस टाइम पर ऐसा कोई भी आपने रिक्वेस्ट एचओडी मैम के पास कि नहीं मुझे इसी सेक्शन में रहना है, मुझे सी सेक्शन में मुझे बी सेक्शन में नहीं जाना, ए सेक्शन में नहीं जाना, ऐसा हम बिल्कुल भी नहीं कर पाएंगे बिकॉज इट इज ऑल अकॉर्डिंग टू द यूनिवर्सिटी प्रोसीजर एंड द एनरोलमेंट नंबर्स विच विल बी प्रोवाइडेड बाय द जीजीएस आईपीयू. सो वी नीड टू फॉलो ऑल द सीक्वेंस रिगार्डिंग द एनरोलमेंट नंबर्स. ओके, सो ये हो गई सेक्शंस की बात. मे बी आज शाम तक आपको सेक्शंस की भी पूरी डिटेल्स मिल जाएंगी. देन उसके बाद आप उन्हीं सेक्शंस के अकॉर्डिंग अपनी क्लास को अटेंड करेंगे, उन्हीं सेक्शंस के अकॉर्डिंग ही आप अपने मेंटर्स के साथ बात करेंगे. जब एनरोलमेंट नंबर आएगा सेक्शंस की डिवीजन होगी, दोबारा से हम फ्रेश लिस्ट को अपडेट करके आपके साथ शेयर करेंगे और देन उसके बाद आपको समझ में आ जाएगा कि हु विल बी द मेंटर ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन ए एंड बी. सी सेक्शन के लिए बेनिफिट ये है कि उनका सेक्शन वही रहेगा बिकॉज दे आर इन शिफ्ट टू. देन कॉलपॉल, कॉलपॉल का मैंने बता दिया, 2nd of January तक थोड़ा सा वेट कीजिए. जैसे ही कॉलपॉल एक्टिवेट होगा हम आपको उसी टाइम पर इमीडिएटली इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोवाइड करेंगे. टिल देन यू विल बी रिसीविंग टू जॉइन द लिंक्स ऑफ पर्टिकुलर सेशंस और मे बी क्लासेस थ्रू व्हाट्सएप कम्युनिकेशन. ओके, देन यस सोसाइटीज, बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स ने पर्सनल मैसेजेस पर पूछा है कि मैम सोसाइटीज ज्वाइन करनी है, कैसे करनी है. फोटोग्राफी सोसाइटी के लिए कल लेट नाइट एक मैसेज आया, देन डांस सोसाइटी के लिए आया. सो सोसाइटीज के लिए ये है, कोशिश कीजिए एक टाइम पर एक ही सोसाइटी ज्वाइन कीजिए बिकॉज जितनी ज्यादा सोसाइटीज आप ज्वाइन करेंगे आप किसी भी सोसाइटी में अच्छे तरीके से सीख भी नहीं पाएंगे और अपनी ड्यूटीज को परफॉर्म भी नहीं कर पाएंगे. दिस इज माई सजेशन. बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ज्वाइन more than one society, not more than two societies, please not at the stake of your classes, because jitni bhi societies is time par kaam kar rahi hain sab 3 baje ke baad kaam karti hain, that is in the physical classroom mode and in the virtual mode as well. Aapko Saturdays aur Sundays devote karne padenge apni jo societies ke kaam ke liye. Aur since फर्स्ट ईयर 2020 बैच का जो है सैटरडे भी इस बार ऑन है टाइम टेबल में, सो यू नीड टू टेक एक्स्ट्रा केयर कि आपकी क्लासेस भी मिस ना हो और आपके जो एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज में आपका जो एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट है वो भी आपका खराब ना हो. सो सोसाइटीज में हमारे पास है थिएटर सोसाइटी, फिल्म एप्रिसिएशन सोसाइटी, म्यूजिक सोसाइटी, डांस सोसाइटी, फोटोग्राफी सोसाइटी, आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट सोसाइटी, लिटरेरी एंड डिबेट सोसाइटी. Then we have sports society and eco club society and we have community connect society. अब इन सोसाइटीज से आपको एक नोटिस आएगा, सब कन्वीनर्स जो हैं सोसाइटीज के वो एक नोटिस आपके साथ शेयर करेंगे, जो नोटिस डीएमई के फेसबुक पेज पर पोस्ट होगा, डीएमई के कॉल पॉल पर पोस्ट होगा, देन आपके मेंटर्स जो हैं आपके जो पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप्स हैं वहां पर उसको पोस्ट करेंगे। सो वहां पर कुछ कन्वीनर्स के या स्टूडेंट कोऑर्डिनेटर्स के कुछ फोन नंबर्स दिए गए हैं, तो आप उन फोन नंबर्स पे कॉन्टेक्ट करके उस पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी को ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं। ठीक है, ये है सोसाइटीज को ज्वाइन करने का जो पैटर्न है। देन उसके बाद सोसाइटीज को जब आप ज्वाइन करेंगे, आपके मेंटर्स को पता होना चाहिए कि आप किस सोसाइटी के पार्ट हैं और किस सोसाइटी के लिए आपकी कौन कौन सी रोल्स और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज हैं, सो दैट कि अगर आपको कोई डिपार्टमेंटल एक्टिविटी में इन्वॉल्व किया जाए या आपको कोई रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी दी जाए और आप सिर्फ सोसाइटीज की वजह से उसको नहीं कर पाते हैं, तो आपके मेंटर को इन सब चीजों के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन होनी चाहिए। नाउ कमिंग टू द कल्चरल एक्टिविटीज, बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स जो होते हैं इंटर और इंट्रा कॉलेज कल्चरल एक्टिविटीज में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं। जब आप इंटर कल्चरल कॉलेज एक्टिविटीज से, फॉर एग्जांपल एक्स वाई जेड कॉलेज का कोई एक्टिविटी है, टेक्निया का है, विप्स का है, ट्रिनिटी का है, जिसका भी है, डीयू के कितने कॉलेजेस के फेस्ट होते हैं, जब आप उनमें पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं, सबसे पहले प्रोटोकॉल को फॉलो करना होगा। यू नीड टू इन्फॉर्म योर मेंटर, यू नीड टू इन्फॉर्म द पीएल ऑफ योर बैच कि आप इस पर्टिकुलर इंटर कॉलेज कॉम्पिटिशन इन वेरियस कैटेगरीज, जिस भी कैटेगरी में आप जा रहे हैं, आपने वहां पर जाना है, आपको दो दिन की, एक दिन की, जितने भी दिन की आपको रिलीविंग चाहिए वो आपको चाहिए, विद प्रूफ कि यस यू आर गोइंग टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर इवेंट। डेफिनेटली आपको कोई ना कोई एक्नॉलेजमेंट रिसिप्ट मिलेगा, आपको कोई शेड्यूल मिलेगा, आपका कहीं ना कहीं नाम होगा, बिना किसी भी मेल कम्युनिकेशन के आप किसी भी इंटर कॉलेज कॉम्पिटिशन में पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करेंगे। देन जब आप पार्टिसिपेट के बाद कॉलेज को रीज्वाइन करेंगे आफ्टर टू और थ्री डेज, जो भी आपके कॉम्पिटिशन के डे हैं, आपने अपना जो भी पार्टिसिपेशन सर्टिफिकेट है और जो भी आपका विनिंग प्राइज हो, और अगर आपका सिर्फ पार्टिसिपेशन सर्टिफिकेट हो, वो प्लीज उसकी इंफॉर्मेशन आपने अपने मेंटर के साथ शेयर करनी है। समझ लीजिए कि आपने अपने मेंटर से कोई भी चीज नहीं छुपानी। यू हैव टू बी इन कॉर्डियल रिलेशनशिप, यू हैव टू बी इन प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन विद योर मेंटर, अदरवाइज बाद में अगर आप किसी प्रॉब्लम में फंसते हैं, बाय डिफॉल्ट अगर आपका अटेंडेंस का कोई इशू है या कोई आपका आई कार्ड का कोई इशू है, लाइब्रेरी का कोई इशू है, जो हमें पहले आपने इन्फॉर्म नहीं किया, तो उस टाइम पर फिर अल्टरनेटिव्स ढूंढने बहुत मुश्किल हो जाते हैं सिचुएशंस को लेकर। सो बेटर इन्फॉर्म योर मेंटर बिल्कुल इनिशियल स्टेज पर, हर चीज की इन्फॉर्मेशन अपने मेंटर्स को दीजिए, सो दैट मेंटर्स आपको गाइड करें कि किस तरीके से आपको आगे आने वाले चीजों के लिए मूव फॉरवर्ड करना है। ओके, देन उसके बाद हमारे पास जो तीन हमारे डिपार्टमेंट की एक्टिविटीज हैं, मेजर एक्टिविटीज, दैट इज द इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस, दैट इज आईकैन। अभी आपको धीरे धीरे आने वाले टाइम में पता चलेगा कि हम इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं, किस तरीके से करते हैं, क्या क्या उसके थीम्स होती हैं, रिसर्च पेपर्स किस तरीके से लिखे जाते हैं, सब चीजें हम आपके साथ टाइम टू टाइम शेयर करेंगे। जस्ट फॉर योर इंफॉर्मेशन, वी हैव सिनेस्ट इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल ऑफ इंडिया एज द मेजर एक्टिविटी ऑफ डीएमई मीडिया स्कूल, then we have international conference as the major activity of DME Media School, then we have our own media fest, that is Ritika, as the major activity of DME Media School. Apart from this, we also celebrate Hindi Divas on in the month of September, on 14 September. Then this is the part of fifth semester students, jo ki unki event management ki jo activity hai, unka jo major subject hai event management ka, usko ye include karta hai. But DME जो मीडिया स्कूल के स्टूडेंट्स हैं वो हिंदी दिवस की बहुत सारी कैटेगरीज में पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं, और उसके बाद पार्टिसिपेट करने के बाद वो अच्छा परफॉर्म करते हैं, विनर्स बनते हैं। सो आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू, आई एम जस्ट इन्फॉर्मिंग यू रिगार्डिंग द वेरियस एक्टिविटीज विच आर बीइंग कंडक्टेड बाय DME मीडिया स्कूल फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम। देन वी हैव स्पार्क टीम। अब आपने बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स ने पूछा था कि वो स्पार्क को ज्वाइन करना चाहते हैं। प्रियंका और कौशिक ने आपके साथ बात की थी कि आप स्पार्क को अगर ज्वाइन करना चाहते हैं तो प्रियंका और कौशिक के साथ बात कीजिएगा, अदरवाइज जो स्पार्क के कन्वीनर हैं, फैकल्टी कन्वीनर, उनकी इंफॉर्मेशन आपके साथ शेयर की जाएगी ग्रुप पर. आप उनको बता सकते हैं कि यू वांट टू बी द पार्ट ऑफ स्पार्क, एंड देन अकॉर्डिंगली आपको आपके रोल्स और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज असाइन किए जाएंगे, और देन उसके अकॉर्डिंगली आप अपने रोल्स और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज को फुलफिल करेंगे. ठीक है, देन उसके बाद स्पार्क जो है, स्पार्क की जो मेजर एक्टिविटीज रहती हैं, जैसे कुछ प्रोमिनेंट डेज होते हैं साल में, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंडिपेंडेंस डे, रिपब्लिक डे, देन टीचर्स डे. तो ये सारी जितनी भी एक्टिविटीज, छोटे छोटे जो इवेंट्स हैं जो आपकी मोनोटनी को ब्रेक करते हैं विद इन योर रूटीन, तो वो स्पार्क की जो कमेटी है वो इनिशिएटिव लेती है इन सब चीज़ों को ऑर्गेनाइज करने के लिए इन अ वेरी हेल्दी मैनर, इन अ वेरी इनोवेटिव मैनर, इन अ वेरी क्रिएटिव मैनर. आई मस्ट से बीइंग द पार्ट ऑफ स्पार्क टीम, you will be able to learn so many things. You will be able to learn the leadership value, the creative aspect in design and graphic, or maybe so many other things which are related to the Spark committee. So I think I have covered all the things related to the working of DME Media School. Pramod sir, main kuch bhool to nahi rahi?
Nahi ma'am, aap kuch nahi bhool rahe, bilkul sahi chal raha hai. मेनली इनका जो है कंसर्न, आपने सब्जेक्ट्स के बारे में बता दिया है, आपने स्पार्क के बारे में, आपने बीजी वर्गीज के बारे में बता दिया है, सेक्शन कैसे डिवाइड होगा वो बता दिया है, सभी इंडिविजुअल टीचर्स ने अपने सब्जेक्ट्स बता दिए हैं. आई थिंक हम इसको वाइंड अप कर सकते हैं. बस अगर स्टूडेंट्स का कोई सवाल है तो वो लिया जा सकता है, और उसके बाद फिर हम इसको वाइंड अप कर देते हैं. आई थिंक
ओके,
मैंने एक चीज कर दिया है कि द स्टूडेंट्स कैन अनम्यूट देमसेल्व्स एंड दे कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन.
ओके, एनीवन, आई सपोज बेटर कि हम टाइप में चैट बॉक्स में ले ले. सुकृति मैम, आई थिंक देयर आर फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, इफ यू कैन टेक अप दोस क्वेश्चंस.
जी मैम, वन ऑफ द थिंग्स इज दैट अबाउट द सेक्शंस दैट हैज बीन आंसर्ड, कॉल पॉल के रिगार्डिंग आपको बता दिया गया है. Attendance link, I believe what they're asking is that attendance for this particular session.
पिछले session का होगा.
हाँ जी, so I think sir, you can provide the link for that.
The chat box and you can get the link from that session. Otherwise, I will be also sharing the attendance link in your respective class groups, that is shift 1 and shift 2 in a short while. मैं अभी session over होते ही वो share करती हूँ. PDF file किसी को syllabus की नहीं मिली. Okay, those who have joined the groups yesterday, I will be sharing the PDF file of the syllabus in a short while. आपके session के बाद आपको syllabus की PDF file भी अभी हम share कर देते हैं. और anything else?
Ma'am, what maybe we can do is that the section wise groups can be created for now, or you can add me to one of the groups because I am not in the common group as of now.
मैम, मैंने ना कल सेक्शन ए बी और सी की क्लास जो है, नाम जो है, और उनके ईमेल आईडी और मोबाइल के साथ मैंने भेज दिया है. ठीक है, आई हैव शेयर्ड इट ऑलरेडी. तो अब जैसे जो ए सेक्शन के हैं या जैसे आप बी सेक्शन के हैं, तो इट कैन बी डन. उसमें ऐसा होगा कि आपको कई स्टूडेंट्स के नंबर की जगह उनके पेरेंट्स का नंबर मिलेगा, बट देन थोड़ा वो हिट एंड ट्रायल के बाद एक ऑफिशियल ग्रुप आपका बन जाएगा. देन सम स्टूडेंट में से कि आप इससे मत बनाए, मैं आपको दूसरा नंबर दे रहा हूँ या दे रही हूँ, सो इट कैन बी डन.
ठीक है,
आई थिंक अभी हम सेशन सर और मैम से पूछकर उनकी परमिशन के साथ सेशन को ओवर करते हैं. फिर हम तीन एक बार थोड़ा सा बात करके अकॉर्डिंगली इस पर डिसीजन ले लेते हैं कि हमें अब सेक्शन वाइज ग्रुप्स को करना है या अभी कॉमन ग्रुप पे आपको ऐड करके अभी इनिशियली ये जो आने वाले तीन दिन है उनके लिए उन्हीं ग्रुप्स पर कम्युनिकेशन रखते हैं. देन फ्रॉम टुमारो ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल बी डिवाइडिंग द सेक्शंस एज पर सेक्शन ए बी एंड सी, व्हाट आई फील. And students, कोई सर पूछ रहे हैं कि स्टूडेंट्स को पता है सेक्शंस के बारे में. सर, अभी हम थोड़ी देर में स्टूडेंट्स को उनके सेक्शंस के बारे में बताएंगे. स्टूडेंट्स बस अगले दो घंटे के लिए आप वेट कीजिए. आपको टाइम टेबल, आपके सेक्शंस के बारे में, पीडीएफ फाइल, सिलेबस के बारे में, सब चीजों के बारे में अभी आपको पता चलेगा. बिकॉज आई थिंक ये उनकी क्वेरीज हैं जिन्होंने उन सेक्शंस को लेट ज्वाइन किया है, जो व्हाट्सएप सेक्शंस हैं. अदरवाइज ओवरऑल पूरी कम्युनिकेशन अच्छे से चल रही है बाकी स्टूडेंट्स के साथ. और रेगुलर क्लासेस कल से आपकी दो सेशंस हैं 28th और 29th के लिए स्पेशली फॉर द क्लासेस ओनली. लाइक कल हम सुकृति मैम और कामिल सर के साथ एक सेशन कर रहे हैं इलेक्टिव क्लासेस के लिए. देन अनदर सेशन विल बी ऑफ द स्पोर्ट्स बुलेटिन बाय मिस्टर सचिन नायर. And after lunch, you will be having another session, which will be conducted by the central level of DME Institute. So, इस तरीके से हमने sessions plan किए हैं. And by Wednesday, we will be conducting your regular classes. Links आपके साथ share किए जाएंगे, timetable आपके साथ share किया जाएगा. बस आप थोड़ा सा और wait कर लीजिए. At least मुझे उन students को join करवाने दीजिए WhatsApp group जिन्होंने अभी तक join नहीं किया. So with all these things, Saxena sir, if you want to share something.
I think most of the information you have already given. As far as the classes and the timetable is concerned, that will be shared by these students. You can tell them what time and the link and the time for tomorrow and day after.
Tentative time for tomorrow session will be 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. बैक टू बैक दो सेशंस होंगे आपके, जो कि आपकी क्लासेस और आपके सब्जेक्ट्स के साथ ही रिलेटेड होंगे. देन पोस्ट लंच सेशन की ऑलरेडी मैंने पीडीएफ ओरिएंटेशन सेशन की आपके साथ शेयर की है, तो वो मैं दोबारा से शेयर कर देती हूँ. एंड फॉर ट्यूसडे एज वेल 10 to 11, 11 to 12 टू सेशंस रिलेटेड टू द सिलेबस एज वेल एज द क्लासरूम सब्जेक्ट्स. एंड देन पोस्ट लंच यू विल बी हैविंग अनदर ओरिएंटेशन सेशन. So,
और अभी जो दोनों ग्रुप्स बने हुए हैं ना मॉर्निंग के और इवनिंग के, उसमें जो स्टूडेंट्स अभी तक जो एंटर नहीं किए हैं वो एंटर कर ले, या किसी का फ्रेंड किसी ने एंटर नहीं किया है तो वो अपने फ्रेंड को बता दे या उसको ऐड करवा दे, जैसे कि वो कंप्लीट कम्युनिकेशन, क्योंकि अगर सारे लोग नहीं होंगे तो कम्युनिकेशन फिर पहुंचेगा नहीं सबके पास.
Exactly. And students, for societies and for Spark, आपको information दी जाएगी कि आपके conveners और student coordinators कौन हैं. ठीक है, कल से Spark और societies का कोई भी काम शुरू नहीं होने वाला. कल आप आइए, पहले अपनी classes को start कीजिए, अपना first year start कीजिए. Then gradually you will get to know how to join the society, how to join the Spark team. Okay, and also gradually you will be the maybe one few of you will be the CR of your class. So थोड़ा सा धीरे धीरे step by step एकदम से आप सारी चीजें कर भी नहीं पाएंगे. Okay, so with this I thank you each and everyone. Sir, ma'am wants to share something or shall I conclude the session?
No, you should conclude the session.
Okay. So with this, I thank you each and everyone to be the part of this PL and introduction session for DME Media School, and see you tomorrow. And we will be sharing all the information related to the syllabus and everything related to joining the classes in a short while on your WhatsApp group. Even I will shoot a mail as well. So don't worry about it. Okay. Thank you, everyone.